Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses as we prepare for the final jewel of the Triple Crown. We have 15 races to bring you, including a big Saturday evening down at Penn National. But we're going to kick it off down in Louisiana, the Evangeline Mile.
They are off in the Evangeline Mile. Dan, the go-to man, going to the front early on, and Iron Fist there on the outside, also moving right up. Down toward the rail is Just Stormin', and Just Stormin', in fact, is going to go on and lead by a length now. Iron Fist will sit second with Dan the Go-To Man inside of Rocket Time. Valiant City moves up on the outside of Fear the Cowboy, who sits sixth here early on. And then the trailing twosome are Grande Basin and the late Running McGee's. 24-64 of a time for the opening quarter, and 50-1 shot. Just Stormin' takes them along. Second is Iron Fist with Rocket Time, now three wide in third and getting closer. Dan, the go-to man, down on the rail, racing in fourth with Fear the Cowboy between horses. Valiant City up on the outside. The two trailers remain Grande Basin and McGee's. The half on the board in 48 and 81 hundredths, and there goes Iron Fist. Iron Fist now comes on to take the lead. Just Stormin' down on the inside and moving up there three wide. Rocket Time. Rocket Time, a nose in front of Iron Fist. The defending champion, Fear the Cowboy, is rounding into form here on the outside. And Dan, the go-to man, is not going away. They're into the stretch. And Iron Fist at the inside with the lead. Fear the Cowboy being urged along by Jesus Rios. Dan, the go-to man, trying to spring an upset. Iron Fist in front. Fear the Cowboy on the outside. Dan, the go-to man, right down to the finish they come. And Iron Fist, I believe, held on to win it. It's a photo with Fear the Cowboy. Iron Fist, Fear the Cowboy hit the line together in the Evangeline Mile. The final time, 1 minute 37 and 62 hundredths.
Iron Fist, the offspring of Tappet, over a sloppy sealed racetrack for Steve Asmussen and Gerard Melanzon. The 6-5 favorite scores the victory by half a length, returning $4.40. Co-second choice in the wagering, Fear the Cowboy finishes second. Dan the go-to man finishes third. Handful of races to bring you from Saturday evening down at Penn National. Up first, the Leafard.
They're off in the Leafard Stakes. And it is first-hand report. Going out for the early lead, Sicy shows speed. Next, the outside is Royal Renegade. First-hand report leads it by two as they come to the finish the first time. Royal Renegade has moved up second, Sicy back to third. Lily's Answer is racing fourth. Next is Pink Elephant. Inside then Imply, joined by Ransom Pass 2. Button My Button is the early trailer. And as they race to the first turn through a quarter of 23-3, first-hand reports put some daylight between herself and the rest of the field, has it by 4.5 lengths. Inside, it is Royal Renegade second. To the outside, Lily's Answer is next. Then comes Pink Elephant. They're then followed by Sicy with Ransom Pass 2. Second last Imply and still trailing Button My Button. Pace was slowed there by Javier Castellana, but he keeps first-hand report on top by a half length. Lily's Answer is second. To the outside, Pink Elephant next. Inside, then, Royal Renegade. They're followed by Sicy and Ransom Pass 2. Imply is on the outside, still trailing here, Button My Button. The half went in 48-4, and first-hand report still is there. But now Lily's Answer's challenging, and Pink Elephant's in the clear, and she's moving up. Here comes Imply with a four-wide bid. Royal Renegade right behind, looking for an opening. Then comes Sicy with Button My Button as they straighten for the drive. First-hand report still holds that lead. Lily's Answer challenging in earnest. Down the center, Imply is coming on. They're followed by Royal Renegade, but first-hand report's holding them all off. Imply, the final challenger. First-hand report, Imply. First-hand report, I think, one at a neck. Imply was right there second. We may have foes for third and fourth in the Leafard Stakes.
Javier Castellano, Todd Pletcher, Star Ladies Racing. They go to the front with first-hand report. They win the photo finish as the 5-2 favorite, returning $7.20. Imply finishes second. Lily's Answer finishes third. Now time to sprint on the turf in the Governor's Cup.
They're off in the Pennsylvania Governor's Cup. For the lead, Bold Thunder the outside. Richard's Boy moves up the rail between horses then. Heiko. Bold Thunder makes the lead by a length. Richard's Boy is second. Heiko races third. Awesome Ghost the outside in the four spot. Take Cover inside is next. Then comes Rainbow Air. And at the back is Oak Bluffs. They race to the turn. Opening quarter, 21-3. Bold Thunder leads at a length and a half. Richard's Boy chases second. Take Cover looks to come on now from third. Heiko is backed off. Then comes Awesome Ghost. Inside, Rainbow Air looks to move closer. Oak Bluff still trails. They're into the stretch in the Pennsylvania Governor's Cup. Bold Thunder leads it by about two. Richard's Boy trying to come on. Take Cover hitting his best stride now. Trying to get involved. Rainbow Air inside. Bold Thunder's holding it off. Richard's Boy is next. Rainbow Air comes on toward the rail. Bold Thunder, Richard's Boy, Rainbow Air. Looks like Bold Thunder held on. Three-way photo for the win. Bold Thunder, Rainbow Air, Richard's Boy in the Governor's Cup.
And a disqualification here. Irad Ortiz at 24-1, taken down on Bold Thunder. Richard's Boy, Paco Lopez, the 3-5 favorite for Peter Miller, elevated to the win position, returning $3.20. Bold Thunder is placed second. Rainbow Air at 5-2 in second choice finishes third. Up next, fillies on the turf in the Pennsylvania Oaks.
They're all in line. They're off in the Penn Oaks. Breaking alertly, Dinah Tail inside. Far outside, here comes Viva Vegas, and also close up is Adorable Miss. Dinah Tail leads it here by a half length. Viva Vegas is second, a break of 2.5, back to Adorable Miss racing third. Spanish Harlem is fourth outside toward the rail, then comes Party Boat, and the two trailers here, Noble Ready and Deodora. Opening quarter, 23 flat as they head to the back stretch. And on top here, it is Dinah Tail. She's got it by a half length. To the outside, Viva Vegas now applying some pressure second, a break of two to Adorable Miss third. In the clear, the outside is Spanish Harlem. Up the rail, then comes Party Boat. Next in line, Deodora, and then about 2.5 lengths to Noble Ready, who is now trailing. They continue on the backstretch here. The half went in 48-3. And Dinah Tail still holds it by about a half length. Viva Vegas races second the outside. Just about a length then to Adorable Miss. Inside then comes Party Boat. Trying to pick it up, Spanish Harlem, Deodora. And now hitting her best stride, Noble Ready, as they head to the top of the stretch. Dinah Tail leads. Viva Vegas is next. Swinging to the outside, Adorable Miss to make her run now. Moving through inside Party Boat. And now Noble Ready with a chance as they race to the eighth pole. It is Dinah Tail getting the challenge now from Adorable Miss. Racing third, Party Boat as she looks to move up. Dinah Tail's holding off all comers. Party Boat is next. Dinah Tail, Luis Saez to win the Penn Oaks. Party Boat got second, Adorable Miss third. It was Noble Ready finishing fourth.
Or the Penn Oaks, if you will. But Luis Saez goes to the front, a theme we heard before, scores the victory on the third choice in the wagering. Dinah Tail returns $11.40. Party Boat finishes second. The 8-5 favorite from Todd Pletcher, Adorable Miss, finishes third in the Penn Oaks. Over to the dirt, the mile and eighth, Mountain View.
They're off in the Mountain View handicap. Paige McKenney came away well toward the inside, Discreet Lover in between that pair, then Matt King Cole. And what's the question? Off the pace, 3.5 lengths early on. Now Matt King Cole goes on with it and takes over three parts as they run to the first turn. Paige McKenney the outside, back to second. Discreet Lover saving the ground third, then about two lengths to What's the Question at the back. Opening quarter, 23-2. A good quarter for the distance, and it will be Matt King Cole setting the pace as they race to the backstretch. In pursuit, Paige McKenney the outside, and Discreet Lover toward the rail, and about 2.5 lengths to What's the Question. Matt King Cole, Irad Ortiz Jr. dictating terms here in the Mountain View. They've got it three parts of a length. Paige McKenney and Horacio Caramanos not going to let them out of their sights. Inside, Jose Flores has Discreet Lover in contention. Then about 3.5, back to What's the Question and Andrew Wolfson. They race to the turn, the half 47-3. And it is Matt King Cole who opens up now a length and a half. Paige McKenney remains in second. Discreet Lover is third, losing ground toward the back then. What's the question as they race to the top of the stretch? Matt King Cole opening up 2.5. Paige McKenney called upon to try to stay in range. Next in line then, Discreet Lover with What's the question as they turn for the wire. Matt King Cole opens up now by 3.5, coming to the eighth pole. Paige McKenney valiantly trying to cut into that margin. Down the center then, Discreet Lover. They come to the 16th pole. Matt King Cole is holding command here. Matt King Cole will score in the Mountain View. Paige McKenney next with Discreet Lover.
Field of four in here, and the 2-5 favorite goes to the front for Linda Rice and Irad Ortiz Jr. Matt King Cole wins by 3.75 lengths, returning $2.80. Second choice in the wagering, Paige McKenney, and finishing third, Discreet Lover. All right, up next, the $500,000 Grade 2 Penn Mile.
They're off in the Grade 2 Penn Mile. Quick beginning for Frostmourne on the outside toward the rail. Time to Travel shows speed, joined in by Sistron. Time to Travel has it next. Sistron right there second. Moving up now, Mo Maverick gains third. Frostmourne back to fourth. Then along the inside, it's Bronson Racing fifth, followed then by Holiday Stone. Next in line, then, it's Big Score. And at the back are the coupling of Prize Fight and Bonus Points. Opening quarter, 23 flat. They move to the backstretch. And with the lead here, Time to Travel has it just ahead. Pressure the outside from Sistron second. About two lengths then to Mo Maverick racing third. Along the rail, Bronson is next. Frostborn is mid-pack, trying to move closer then, Holiday Stone. They're then followed by Big Score, Bonus Points, Prize Fight still at the rear. The half 47-2, and they race to the far turn in the Penn Mile. And it is Time to Travel, and Sistron still battling for command. Looking to come on from third now is Mo Maverick. Bronson inside is next. Coming on now, Frostborn the outside. Trying to move up then, it is Holiday Stone with Big Score as they've reached the head of the lane. The first six furlongs, 1:12. Time to Travel along with Sistron continue to battle. Looking to move up from between horses, Mo Maverick. Also coming on now to the outside, here's Frostborn. Frostborn, a scintillating turn of foot, followed by Big Score. Frostborn, Irad Ortiz to win the Penn Mile. Big Score was second. There'll be photos for third and fourth.
Christophe Clement, Irad Ortiz Jr., the offspring of Spicetown, off the pace for Frostmore, scoring the victory by a length and a quarter, returning $8.40. The 9-5 favorite, Big Score, finishes second. Sistron finishes third. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Monmouth Park and Churchill Downs.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love racing? RTN brings you every live simulcast on your home television, plus live video streaming and race replays on your PC and mobile devices. To order, visit RTN.tv. RTN, a breed apart.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTV's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTV mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play. In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn your attention to Monmouth Park. I know it's a Grade 3, but pay attention to this one. Phillies and Mares in the Eatontown.
And
They're off in the Eaton Town, and Cali 37 wastes no time going straight to the front, trying to cross over, but Quiet Kitten has something to say about that, and Quiet Kitten is up to take the lead. Zepesa is third, racing on the outside of Bishop's Pond. Then it's a gap of four, back to Hip Hop and Jazz, racing inside Light in Paris. The favorite, Grand Jeté, is more than a dozen off this swift early tempo. All in Fun is just outside of her. They're followed by Sean, who's third last, Tin Type Gal, second to last, and the early trailer is Tricky Escape. Around the first turn they go, and it's Quiet Kitten, the long shot, leading it by a length with Cali 37, keeping her honest in second. Zepesa gets a good spot, as does Bishop's Pond along the inside. They're third and fourth, and only 2.5 lengths off the lead. Then comes Hip Hop and Jazz, inching up just a bit on the inside of Light in Paris. All in Fun covers Grand Jeté, who's down at the rail, 9 lengths off the lead. Then comes Tin Type Gal, who's 3 wide. Tricky Escape trying to advance along the inside of her, and Sean between those two. Around the far turn they go. Cali 37, Quiet Kitten have been 1-2 throughout. Zepesa with a dream journey makes a 3 wide and bold bid. And Zepesa comes looking for the lead with a quarter of a mile to go, and she takes it. Light in Paris in the orange cap is starting to rally. Grand Jeté is looking for racing room. She's got some run. Swinging to the far outside, has to catch Zepesa in the final eighth of a mile. Zepesa by a length. Grand Jeté takes off on the far outside, and she comes with beautiful strides. Grand Jeté, in a powerful performance, storms home in the Eaton Town. Light in Paris was second. Tricky Escape came from last to be in a photo for third with Zepesa.
Chad Brown, Judmont Farms, Jersey Joe Bravo on the 3-2 favorite. I got to tell you, folks, I think appreciably bigger fish are going to be fried here by this runner, an offspring of Dan Silly, who I think the world of for Judmont, who I believe was a homebred runner for them. But the winner returns $5 even. Light in Paris, second choice, finishes second. And the third choice, Zepesi, finishes third in this year's renewal of the Eaton Town. All right, I know I said Churchill Downs earlier, but it is Woodbine we're headed to for a pair of weekend stakes action. Up first on Saturday afternoon, the Connaught Cup.
Off their race. And Slow Dimension, about two behind. Tower of Texas drops to second last and take the stand in front as they go from Safira. Commute moving up on the outside with Great Wide Open. A length and a half, Glenville Gardens mid-pack. Then Tower of Texas on the inside of Hollywood Hideaway Calgary Cat. And a length away last is Dimension. It's Take the Stand in front, by a head, pressed by Commute, and they're 2.5 clear. Right behind them, Great Wide Open, closing a little bit of ground, a length and a half, Safira in fourth. Two away, Glenville Gardens, Tower of Texas, two to Hollywood Hideaway, Dimension, and Calgary Cat has dropped to last. A half mile to run, about 10 lengths covers the field, and racing away is Commute, and Patrick Husbands marching out in front, about 2.5 clear. In second placing, Take the Stand, two away, Great Wide Open, up the inside, Safira, a length to Glenville Gardens, Tower of Texas making run now in the center, on the outside, Dimension, top of the lane in the Connaught Cup, and Commute turns in front, two to Take the Stand, trying to get home is also Great Wide Open, Tower of Texas, Calgary Cat, and Hollywood Hideaway. Out in front, Commute. Commute by two lengths. Calgary Cat right down the outside, and Tower of Texas. And the veteran gallopers are coming after Commute. Tower of Texas and Calgary Cat and Commute. And they come down to the wire. Three of them go to the line. Tower of Texas in the center, and a photo with Commute and Calgary Cat. A great three-way photo finish. 1:20:13 the time.
And it's Tower of Texas winning outside of Toronto. Roger Atfield, Enrique Rosa da Silva scores the victory in the photo finish with three horses. The offspring of Street Sense returns $8.20 as the favorite. Commute finishes second. Calgary Cat finishes third. Sunday afternoon, Phillies and Mares in the Hendry.
Off they race in the Hendry Stakes. Jennifer Lynette pinged the best, but going to the lead, Miss Ella within the center, Code Warrior, and Chic Thrill on the inside. And they're the top four from Blurricane. And right through in the center, Rat-a-Tap-Tap. Crumlin Spirit on the inside is back, fourth last in the early stages, and towards the back of Cactus Copy Rivermaid, and the trailer is Mink Surprise, and Chic Thrill has assumed the lead on the inside from Code Warrior. Chic Thrill by a neck, Code Warrior second, a length and a half away, Jennifer Lynette going up three wide, Miss Ella the center, Rat-a-tap-tap has the box seat on the inside, a length and a half to Cactus Copy and Crumlin Spirit. Blurricane dropped 2.5 behind them from Rivermaid, and Mink Surprise gets up on the inside. On the outer, going for Code Warrior to join Chic Thrill. A length away, Jennifer Lynette, Miss Ella, and Rat-a-tap-tap on the inside. One to Cactus Copy and Crumlin Spirit as they go down towards the quarter. Rivermaid is third last with Mink Surprise, and Blurricane is now last, and Code Warrior's gone out in front and got a length on them. Jennifer Lynette up on the outside second. Chic Thrill is struggling. Miss Ella the center, but Code Warrior by a length and a half to Jennifer Lynette, and down the lane they're clear. And Code Warrior holding out nicely here from Jennifer Lynette. River May with a late burst down the outside, but it is Code Warrior. And Code Warrior from Mink Surprise out the ground to second. Jennifer Lynette third. River May in a fourth place photo with Miss Ella. And then a Rat-a-tap-tap and Cactus Copy. 116.80.
Upset in here. Code Warrior at almost 12-1 scores the three-quarter length victory, returning $25.80. Mink Surprise finishes second. Jennifer Lynette finishes third. Miss Ella, the 2-1 favorite, finishes fourth in Sunday's Hendry. We're going to a quick break, and when we come back, now we'll have stakes action from Churchill Downs.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Not at the track and not near a computer? No problem. Wager with Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System and you'll never get shut out again. Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System is quick, simple to use, and guarantees your wagers are accurate and placed on time. For more information, visit CapitalOTB.com or call Capital OTB's customer service hotline at 800-292-BETS. Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System. Never get shut out again.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn our attention to Churchill Downs, a pair of stakes races on Saturday afternoon. Up first, the Mighty Bow.
And they're off. Not a good start for Leighton Revenge. Forgive bounces out on top, and Platinum Prince is also there. Grand Candy on the outside, expected ruler. Leighton Revenge making up for that lost time. Races up to be third on the outside. Moving up the backstretch, Forgive and Platinum Prince head-to-head. Leighton Revenge comes up three wide of the outside. Third, Rivers Run Deep Racing. Fourth, Grand Candy. Fifth, expected ruler down inside. Six, Partly Mocha's in seventh, and Vici's at the back at eighth. Onto the far turn they go. Platinum Prince going head-to-head with Forgive. Leighton Revenge is poised on their outside. Long shot chance for expected ruler in behind. Rivers Run Deep is spun wide. Partly Mocha cuts to corner. Grand Candy is there too. Top of the stretch now. Forgive down inside of Platinum Prince. These two head to head for the lead. Grand Candy trying to close in. Partly Mocha's in behind. Expected ruler's there too. Vici down the center of the course with Rivers Run Deep. 100 yards to go. Forgive is digging down. Platinum Prince, Partly Mocha. Final surges on the outside. Three noses on the wire. Photo! Forgive, Partly Mocha, and Platinum Prince in a three-horse photo. Grand Candy fourth.
The offspring of Sydney's Candy, Forgive, scores the victory in the three-horse photo finish on the turf. Mike Tomlinson sends out the winner. Joe Rocco Jr. scores the upset victory, returning $18.60. Partly Mocha finishes second. Platinum Prince finishes third. Leighton Revenge, the 2-1 favorite, finishes last in Saturday's Mighty Bow. Also on the card Saturday afternoon, we remain sprinting, but this time in the dirt, the Aristides.
And they're off. The Truth Rounds with a good start. So too Union Jackson, who races up on through to take over the lead. So it is Union Jackson out to set the pace. ABBA to the inside is running in second. Chivarelli is up close third. Limousine Liberal in the clear while fourth. Wibbles fifth. Six lengths back already to the Truth or Else, the last of them all. So it is Union Jackson showing the way up the backstretch run. Plenty of company, though. Here is Wilbo now coming on to apply some pressure from second. Chivarelli is three wide in third. Limousine Liberal stuck four wide racing fourth on the far turn. ABBA's in behind while fifth and still about eight lengths back to the Truth or Else. Three furlongs to go, 21 and four the opening quarter. Union Jackson going head-to-head with Wilbo. Limousine Liberal, wide trip on the far turn, racing up to be third. Chivarelli's back into fourth, ABBA's fifth. The Truth or Else has caught up to the pack and swings wide for the stretch drive. Off the turn now. Wilbo in between horses. Union Jackson fights on. Limousine Liberal to the attack. And the Truth or Else is closing in. There's one furlong to go. Limousine Liberal has come on to take the lead now. Wilbo battles on, but he's back into second. Union Jackson third. The Truth or Else in fourth. Down to the finish. And Limousine Liberal under the wire to win it by two. Wilbo was second, the Truth or Else was third, and Union Jackson finished fourth.
Boy, and this runner certainly has found his footing at 5 years of age. Limousine Liberal wins again at Churchill Downs, this time by 2.5 lengths for Ben Colbrook and Corey Landry. The 3-5 favorite returns $3.20. Wilbo finishes second, the Truth or Else finishes third. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll have Grade 1 action from Santa Anita and Belmont Park.
And Frosted is coming with giant strides on the far outside.
EquestriCon.
The first ever international racing convention.
The first ever.
For the fans.
Meet the legends.
The breeders, the owners.
The jockeys like me.
The best of the industry.
Come celebrate racing at EquestriCon.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Santa Anita, and it's a time of year when we have many former Hollywood Park stakes races moved across town. Up next, Grade 1 action, part of the 1 Mile Turf Series that is outstanding in Southern California. This time, it's the Shoemaker.
Racing. What a view and heart to heart. Win the start together. Bolo is away sharply. And so is Free Rose in the blue blinkers. They share third. Then Bala Bali, Gangster quickly crossing to the rail. And a gap of three lengths, Farhan. Heart to heart at the 7/8 pole, a neck in front of What a View, one length to Bolo. Free Rose the fence, Bala Bali fifth, Gangster is six lengths off the lead, Farhan last. Around the first turn, six furlongs to go, heart to heart in front of What a View, puts a length on him. Two lengths to Free Rose in company with Bolo. Bala Bali fifth, five from the front. Three to Gangster and a length and a half, Farhan. Into the back stretch and heart to heart leads the Shoemaker field by 3/4 of a length, What a View. 2.5 lengths to Bolo. Free Rose ahead back on the inside. Bala Bali solo in fifth and a gap of 3 lengths to Gangster. And back with him is Farhan at the half mile pole. 11 lengths covering the field. Heart to heart. Front running tactics this year beneath Leperu into the far final turn comes Heart to Heart, one length to the good of What a View. A length and a half to Bolo, who's been passed on the inside by Free Rose. He's working forward. And then Bala Bali getting to the outside. Gangster through along the fence is within five of the lead. And Farhan still last, turning for home. And Heart to Heart kicks away 2.5 lengths. Free Rose moving into second. Bala Bali is down the outside. Gangster running a good race on the fence next from Farhan, who's still a long way back, running on belatedly. Heart to Heart at the 16th pole, a length from Bala Bali. Free Rose, Farhan late on the scene. Bala Bali gathers in Heart to Heart. Farhan charging, but Bala Bali wins the Shoemaker from either Farhan or Heart to Heart, followed in by Free Rose.
Bala Bali sets a new stakes record, ladies and gentlemen. The old one set across town at the old Hollywood Park 23 years ago. Megan's Intergo went 132.64. Well, Bala Bali goes 132.22. Scores the victory for Mike Smith and Richard Mandela. The winner returns $8.20. Farhan finishes second. And last year, as the 4-5 beaten favorite, this time 5-2 beaten favorite, Heart to Heart finishes third. Up next, in my youth and up until this year, used to be known as the Vanity, shortened up to a mile last year, renamed the Beholder.
Racing. Vale d'Ori just in front of Finer City through the opening bounds of the race. Stellar Wind on the inside. Smith backing off on Finest City, and Espinosa slices between the pair and ranges up on the outside to fire an early salvo at the 7/8 pole, and Vale d'Ori in front gets away again by a length. Stellar Wind in stalking mode to second, and Finest City, to the surprise of several, I imagine, is back last of the three onto the back stretch, where it's Vale d'Ori just in front of Stellar Wind, who moves up within a head. Two lengths to Finest City. The triumvirate of Elite Mares makes the run along the Santa Anita back stretch, and Vale d'Ori holds the lead a half length, pursued by Stellar Wind and Finest City. The minor place getters last year behind the mighty mare for whom this race has been renamed. They're at the half mile, and the lead belongs to Vale d'Ori, a neck to Stellar Wind, and two lengths to Finest City. Vale d'Ori into the far turn by a neck. With Stellar Wind, she's been stalking in predatory fashion, moves within a head midway around the far turn. Finest City 2.5 lengths away. Vale d'Ori clinging to the most narrow of leads. Stellar Wind is right up alongside of her as they swing for home, three clear of Finest City. It's Vale d'Ori on the inside, and Stellar Wind stride for stride past the 3/16 pole. Vale d'Ori, Stellar Wind with steely determination on the outside. Vale d'Ori straining every sinew to keep her streak alive. Stellar Wind comes at her powerfully now. Stellar Wind with the nose in front of Vale d'Ori, and Stellar Wind over Vale d'Ori in the thrilling Beholder Mile. Finest City, never a serious factor, was five lengths away third.
The field of three in here, and a race that's had the likes of Princess Rooney, Bayakoa, Gorgeous, Passiana, Asina, Azeri twice, Zenyatta three times, Blind Luck. That's many Eclipse Award, ladies and gentlemen. And now you can add Stellar Wind, a very exciting photo finish victory for the 1-2 shot, John Sadler. Victor Espinosa, the offspring of Curlin, returns $3 even. Vale d'Ori finishes second. And Finest City, the sprinter, runs last around the racetrack. Sunday afternoon, Distaff is on the turf going 10 furlongs in the possibly perfect.
Racing. Stylish in Black wins the start, headed by Lacine. Then comes Responsible for Love, who's going up for a share of the lead. In fact, she takes it up the running now, as Lacine is inclined to drift a little bit wide over the crossing. Place des Vosges just in behind the leader on the inside. September Stars, a hot pink cap between horses within three lengths of the pace. Hiking and Stylish in Black, the last couple. Responsible for Love, with the ears pricked, strides away to lead by almost four lengths from Lacine, followed by Place des Vosges, September Stars, a length and a half Stylish in Black. Hiking on the inside, last of all. Five-length lead for Responsible for Love as they work out of the home stretch. Lacine running second, Place des Vosges third on the inside of September Stars from Stylish in Black, hiking on the fence. fence. Six furlongs left to go. Responsible for Love, a six-length leader. Lacine is second. Two lengths Place des Vosges, kept company by the favourite September Stars. Stylish in Black next to last with Hiking at the tail of the field. 5/8 left to run. Responsible for Love getting right on with the job. Opens up eight lengths on Lacine, Place des Vosges, September Stars, Stylish in Black and Hiking in the vicinity of the half-mile pole. It's Responsible for Love. Responsible for Love leading by nine lengths from Lacine, Place des Vosges, who moves a length and a quarter in front of September Stars at this juncture, with Hiking fifth on the inside of Stylish in Black. They approach the 5/16, and Responsible for Love's lead is evaporating. Place des Vosges railing to second is in hot pursuit of the former Tearaway leader. Then Lacine, Stylish in Black, and September Stars fifth, with Hiking on her inside. 3/16 to go. Responsible for Love a length and a half from Place des Vosges. September Stars splits horses. Stylish in Black running a decent race down the outside. Hiking on the fence. 16th to go, and September Stars lengthening now. Here comes September Stars to grab the lead close to home, and wins in hand yet again from Responsible for Love, Place des Vosges, Stylish in Black next.
September Stars, the offspring of See the Stars, Patty Gallagher, Gary Stevens, the 3-5 shot wins by 3/4 of a length, returning $3.20. Responsible for Love finishes second. Place des Vosges finishes third in the possibly perfect. Headed back east, Belmont Park, as they prep for Belmont Stakes Week, one stakes race to bring you on Saturday afternoon, the Pennine Ridge.
They're off in the Pennine Ridge.
Great again. He bumped around.
Always Hero broke well from the inside. Oscar Performance up and on the pace. Secretariat War is away running in third in the far outside. Then Mugs-O-Matic, Makarios, Good Samaritan outside of horses. Ticonderoga's last. Taken back about six lengths off of front running Oscar Performance, who will make the pace here in the Pennine Ridge on top a length and a half. Secretariat War on the outside second. Bowie's Hero is third onto the backstretch and tucked in. And then it's Mugs-O-Matic, Makarios, followed outside by Good Samaritan and Ticonderoga's last. 24.43 was the opening quarter mile. Going along at a sensible early pace here, it is Oscar Performance, a Breeders' Cup winner, on top by a neck up the backstretch. Prompted by Secretariat War on the outside, Bowie's Heroes a length and a half off of them. And then it's Mugs-O-Matic and Makarios together. Two lengths more back to the favorite Good Samaritan, who right now has six lengths to make up and is just ahead of Ticonderoga. Oscar Performance has run a 49.92 half mile and makes his run for the far turn in charge here by a length and a half. Secretariat War on the outside, still second. Not much has changed so far. Bowie's Hero continues to ride the rail, just in behind the leader. Then Mugs-O-Matic, Makarios, Good Samaritan, Ticonderoga, six lengths off the lead at the back of the pack as they round the far turn. Oscar Performance, the leader. Secretariat War putting the pressure on now, and the two of them will come to the top of the stretch together. And a wide run for Good Samaritan, who's coming four deep as they turn for home. Oscar Performance cuts the corner, tries to keep the lead. Mugs-O-Matic, Good Samaritan, Secretariat War, Bowie's Hero down on the inside, and Ticonderoga still trying to come and get Oscar Performance, who may have enough left. Good Samaritan's making a late bid, but not good enough. Oscar Performance is back, wiring the field in the Pennine Ridge. And then it was Good Samaritan in a photo with Ticonderoga, followed by Bowie's Hero. The final time was 1 minute 48.44 seconds.
Oscar Performance goes to the front, the offspring of Kitten's Joy, trained by Brian Lynch. Jose Ortiz in the saddle. Second choice in the wagering scores the upset victory, returning $9.80. The 4-5 favorite, Good Samaritan, finishes second. Ticonderoga finishes third in this year's renewal of the Pennine Ridge. Well, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your stakes action around the country, particularly at Belmont Park. And we'll see you next time on Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off Track Betting.